I'm reviewing OBD2 scanners. Hola, I'm Mike, the backyard mechanic. I have an announcement about a major change to my videos. Stay until the end for that. The main topic is I will be reviewing two scanners, first the DND Plus Echo and then the Kingbolen S500. But what is an OBD2 scanner and why do you need it? Due to complex electronics and emissions controls, all cars since 1996 have come with a second version of an onboard diagnostics port, or OBD2 port. There are many computers in modern vehicles which go by different names, but we are mainly concerned with the power control module, or PCM. The PCM continually runs tests on various systems, and if one of these tests fails, it will trigger a diagnostic trouble code, or DTC. The OBD2 scanner has been around since 1996. Previous versions of OBD would run tests, but upon failure there was no code, just a check engine light. True car enthusiasts who preferred a temperature gauge, vacuum gauge, and a battery gauge instead referred to it as a moron light. An imbecile light? Idiot light. But now we have scanners, which we can plug into the car and ask, "Hey car, what's wrong with you?"
"Nothing's wrong with me, Michael. What's wrong with you?"
I didn't realize the Mustang was so defensive. "Hey, it's cool. I'm just going to plug this in and see if you have any diagnostic trouble codes."
"I've taken the liberty of scanning your vitals, Michael. Your temperature and oxygen levels are normal, but your cholesterol could kill a corn-fed hog. I blame the Cheetos."
My Cheeto habit is a violation of HIPAA rules, so we should instead talk about the different types of scanners. Basic scanners are simple devices that read and clear codes. This fixed scanner is an example of that, although you can pay for upgrades and make it enhanced. Basic functionality only checks emissions, so if any other part of your car is malfunctioning that does not trip the engine light, like your HVAC system for example, this type of scanner will not report it. Enhanced scanners provide advanced diagnostics, manufacturer-specific codes, and live data. The DND Plus and the Kingbolen are examples of enhanced scanners. A basic scanner simply reports on the current codes. An enhanced scanner puts the car into test mode, like increasing RPMs, turning the engine fan on and off, and does a thorough test of all systems. I've shown the live functionality before of testing my O2 sensors, but you can also get live data from voltage, airflow, fuel pressure, etc. Enhanced scanners often have system reset functions, like resetting your oil status and electronic emergency brake in the battery. Professional scanners are high-end devices used by mechanics and technicians. The Autel that I use is an example of a professional scanner, although this is a low-end one. Professional scanners have software updates to keep up with new models of cars and updates to existing models, although this usually comes at the cost of a yearly subscription. One of the primary benefits of a professional scanner is the bidirectionality, meaning it can control your car, albeit with limitations. I used bidirectionality when I was debugging my HVAC system to open and close vents. You can also check lights, locks, and many other things. Which one is right for you? A simple and inexpensive code reader is a nice thing to have for the average driver who knows nothing about cars but would like to know why their engine light is on. Of course, a PO420 isn't exactly brimming with information for grandma.
"My car is throwing a 420. I take it it's time for my glaucoma medicine." "Yeah, it's always time for my glaucoma medicine."
An enhanced scanner is perfect for the DIYer or your backyard mechanic. When a code comes up with a dozen potential symptoms, many of these can be eliminated by the live tests, like making sure the engine is getting enough fuel pressure and air. A professional scanner is for professionals, masochists, and the extremely patient. They are not intuitive. The bidirectionality is great, and some allow you to program keys or your TPMS systems, but you end up paying for a lot of functionality that you might not know how to use or know is even there. The DND Echo is an enhanced scan tool that connects to your phone with Bluetooth. Ratchet helped me unbox the dongle and open the instructions. I downloaded the DND app using the QR code in the instruction booklet. The app is free and it comes with lifetime updates. Plug it in. The OBD port is most often under the dashboard on the driver's side. The Bluetooth connection isn't novel, but it's very convenient, and this one is very fast. By the time you open the app, it already recognizes your car. They claim it's 70% faster than other devices, and it very well might be. It's faster than my Autel. My Autel is very, very slow. It has multiple connection protocols, including OBD2 and CAN-FD. I started with the OBD scan, and it shows the Mustang has two codes, which is correct. The headers are leaking. Future content. Not all do, but these codes have more information behind them. The problem is the O2 sensors are responding slowly. It gives potential fixes, and one of them is indeed correct, an exhaust leak. Let's try Enhanced Diagnostics. This detects all the systems in the car that can be tested. This is the menu of all the items, ABS, body control, HVAC, etc. I'm going to select PCM and see if there are any other problems. Selecting Read Codes, which I'm going to do with the engine running, puts the engine through its tests and takes a few minutes. This does pick up more codes, but with experience, you'll learn their importance. The P1000, when the engine light is off, means your car doesn't have enough miles on it to tell you if something is wrong. The P1000, when the engine light is on, means your car is not ready to pass emissions, which is where the Mustang is, because of the header leak. The HVAC and brake codes typically happen during a test. You're supposed to hit the brakes at a certain point, and I never do. You're also supposed to run the test with the AC off, but it's 100 degrees outside. It's quite thorough. It has reset functions for oil status, an electronic emergency brake, and battery. It of course works with Android as well as the iPhone. You don't have to use their app. It works with other third-party apps, so you can use your favorite. It supports all vehicles for basic scans, and it supports all Japanese and American cars for enhanced scans. This scanner will pay for itself over cheaper scanners when scanning more than a few vehicles. The Kingbolen S500 is an enhanced scanner with a touchscreen display and an Android 6 system. Ratchet helped me unbox it. I tell you, if it was up to Ratchet, the Kingbolen might be the best scanner ever. He loves it. It connects to your car with a serial cable, which Ratchet also loves. He says it tastes like licorice. I plugged in the cable. I know you're thinking there's no way a cable is acceptable when there is the ability to go wireless with Bluetooth, but trust me, it doesn't matter. You're sitting in the car anyway. The first thing you need to do is connect to your Wi-Fi. Don't start the car yet, because next the device should be updated. After updating, run the quick OBD scan. It determines the protocol to connect, connects, and then discovers the VIN to the car. The malfunction indicator lamp status is on, which I know, and the number of diagnostic trouble codes are 2. Click that, click read fault codes, and there are my slow sensor codes again. You can generate a report easily. Click the PDF button, and it's created. Now click share, and you can email the report to yourself. You can also do this with screenshots and recordings. I like that feature a lot. My Autel has an email feature, but I could never figure out how to set it up properly. Now let's back out and do diagnostics and auto search. Now the VIN is discovered with a Las Vegas slot machine. Yay! I want a Ford Mustang! The S500 has discovered codes in the ABS and the PCM. I click the ABS first, read the fault codes, and I'm going to just retrieve the codes, not do a full test. It has discovered that my brake fluid is low, and the other two codes don't sound scary at all. I would add brake fluid and diagnose my CAN system, but that's beyond the scope of this video. Now the PCM, and I'm going to run the full test. I get a warning that I should not perform a PCM test while driving down the highway. Check. The test takes a few minutes to run, and like my other tests, I get the HVAC codes because the AC is running, and the P1000 because I have emissions problems with my O2 sensors. The generated report of all the errors is concise and easy to read. The S500 also has 4 reset functions for the oil, emergency brake, steering sensor, and electronic throttles. It supports 75 car brands, including European. What I don't like about it is it found some work for me to do on my car. What I do like is you hitting that like button. No, I'm serious. Hit the like button. I'll wait. Thanks. If you're interested in the DND Plus or the Kingbolen, use my links in the description. When you do this, I get a kickback. I'm hoping that if enough people do this, we can bankrupt Amazon. This week is Amazon Prime Day. These will be on sale and you will save money. Shout out to Houston. Now I'd like to address a comment from my last video. You asked what you were doing wrong for not getting heaps of views. The answer is your failed attempt of comedy. Constructive criticism taken, and I thank you, M. Dippa. Where's the emphasis in that, by the way? M. Dippa or M. Dippa or M. Dippa? Is the M for mother? Is that you, Mom? Regardless, M. Dippa was obviously not a fan of my dancing, so no more dancing for me. That bit was obviously a stretch. And was maybe a little bit corny. So in order to appease my most constructive commenter, no more dancing in my videos. I told you there'd be a major change. Oh, I have a fan online. Hey, fan. Did you enjoy the video?
Good reviews. You know, I bought the OBD-1 Kenobi scanner, but it turns out it doesn't have the codes I'm looking for.
Thanks, fan. After you buy one of these scanners and you're in the buying mood, check out these 20 gift ideas and buy yourself something pretty.
I think you're pretty, Michael.
We'll talk about that later. Lights are off. You missed the show. Oh, you want this money, don't you? You want that money.